Well, the hottest thing in Normal, Illinois, folks, isn't the weather. It's the ticket to the I-74 series. Welcome to Redbird Arena as Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company proudly presents our Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week as the Redbirds of Illinois State get set to take on the Bradley Braves. Hello, everyone. Along with Dave Kaplan, I'm Scott Warman. Great to have you alongside, Dave. This is probably the fiercest rivalry we have in the Missouri Valley Conference between these two teams.
Well, no other schools are 35 miles apart, so you've got great history. Think back to the players, Doug Collins, the courts named after him, Dick Versace coaching over at Bradley, Jimmy Less, a Sweet 16 team, Bob Donawal, Kevin Stallings, Bob Bender. It's a great rivalry because of players and coaches and really intense fan bases.
Well, this rivalry just last month at Carver Arena, and the Bradley Braves come out on top, and they really beat Illinois State at their own game defensively.
They did. They went to the zone. ISU either runs the 1-3-1 or the 2-3. The key tonight, though, is going to be offensively. Will they attack a zone? Will they look for the first shot, or will they look for the best shot opportunity in the 35 seconds that they're given? Patience and attack.
Dave, we know there's been a lot of great players that have played at Bradley. Walt Lemon is one of those great players.
Walt Lemon is a scorer. He's got a scorer's mentality. Got a chance to move into maybe seventh all-time in Bradley history if he finishes the season on a real high note. This guy can miss a couple shots and go, I'm okay, I'm going to keep jacking. And Geno Ford lets him. He puts it on the deck, and he attacks the rim. He's a heck of a scorer.
Illinois State has a scorer, Nick Zeisloff, and he did it in a close but incredible comeback against Evansville on Wednesday.
Yeah, it came from 21 down at the break to get it into overtime. It was a game 200-point score between the two teams. He's not the scorer that Walt Lemon is. He's the shooter, though. This guy has a limited range, and when they let him set his feet, look out, because he can bury it from 30.
Birds and Braves getting set to battle in the I-74 Series Part 2. These two teams tied in conference plays. We're winding down the conference season. Starting lineups, opening tip, headed your way next from Normal. The Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week is brought to you by Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company, the official presenting sponsor for the NBC TV network. By Emerson, the proud presenting partner of the Larry Bird Trophy. Emerson, consider it solved. And by Casey's General Store. Casey's, famous for pizza. Back at Redbird Arena, it's our Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week as you see the Redbirds making their way into Redbird Arena. And the fans are piling up here in Central Illinois for the I-74 series between the Birds and the Braves. Geno Ford, the head coach at Bradley, fifth all-time in scoring in the mid-90s during his days as a player at Ohio University. Only MAC coach, Mid-American Conference coach, to have back-to-back MAC championships for a team in 48 years. Now he moves from Kent State to Bradley, 3 years in Peoria. Let's take a look at our starting lineups, brought to you by Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company. Visit CoventryHealthcare.com for more information, health, wellness, Coventry Healthcare. We mentioned Walt Lemon Jr. When you look at Greer, Lemon Jr., Barnes, Pickett, and Taylor, there is a lot of experience in that great starting lineup.
A lot of experience and guys who really, I think, are on a mission to end a streak that goes back to 2007 that they haven't won in this building.
Lee, Knight, Hunter, Zeisloff, and Lynch inside a shot blocking machine.
Well, Nick Zeisloff can fill it up, and Reggie Lynch can become the eraser inside if you make a mistake when you're in your zone concept. But I really think it's important for Illinois State, when they're in that zone, to come out, extend, not give up the early shots we saw a week ago against Loyola, where the extra pass, wide open looks, let them build the work in margin and withstand any run.
There's Dan Moeller in his second year here at Illinois State. Of course, a great player here at Redbird Arena. Back the last player to lead an Illinois State team to two NCAA tournament appearances.
98, the last one.
That's right. Series history between these two teams. Of course, long history. The Redbirds have won six straight here in Normal, but the Braves have won two of the last three meetings, as this is meeting number 118 between these two rivals, and a huge crowd here at Redbird Arena, and we are underway in Central Illinois.
Love love the old school unis for Illinois State.
Love them. Pickett misses our first shot of the evening. This is Paris Lee, just a freshman from Maywood, Illinois. Dan Moore transforming his team from last year to this year with 11 new faces. And Daishon Knight gets our first bucket of the evening.
Well, real nice job to get him on a curl move, get him in his comfort zone. Nobody around him. He catches, squares the shoulders, buries the quick shot.
Lemon on the draw.
Watch him on a curl move here. Here comes Knight. He's going to square his shoulders. Here he comes. Great screen. Picks off the defender. Just let me load it up and knock it down. Big time screen. Very well done by Illinois State, Reggie Lynch.
To the line, brand number 22.
Open junior. What an incredible career, in fact. At least 20 points scored in 8 of the 13 Valley games he has played this season. In fact, Dave Kaplan, he is just 2 assists shy of getting 350 assists with his 1,600 points and over 200 steals. Only 3 other players in Valley history have been able to accomplish that. Darren Brooks of Southern Illinois, Percy Hawkins of Bradley, and a guy by the name of Larry Bird.
He was a decent player.
He was all right. Hawkins can light it up every once in a while, too.
I recruited Hersey, and we didn't get him when I was at Northern Illinois. Had we gotten him, we might have been sitting next to you.
That's right. You got up to DeKalb and calling some of your games.
He could really play. Nick Forsaith did a great job at Bradley. Greer over the top.
All right, let's get to Dave's keys for tonight's contest.
But some of them are already starting to show themselves early in the game here. I mean, we're only almost a minute and a half in. Okay, you got to look. For Bradley, it's got to be one and done. Make the extra pass. Illinois State, don't settle for the first open look and extend the zone. Take away easy three-point opportunities like they did a week ago in a loss at Loyola.
Just off the mark by Bobby Hunter. Here with the diagonal pass, and they're going to say that's off Bradley. Turnover, Illinois State basketball.
Yeah, it was off Xavier Taylor. It was tipped, changed the angle he was expecting it at on the pass over the top, as you see Geno Ford barking out some signals, and it went out of bounds.
You know, 4-2-3 in his early coaching career in Peoria against the rival. Knight hits the triple.
Nice extra pass. Nick Zeislav. Good. Clean look from the corner. That's what we talk about. Make the extra pass.
Illinois State had an incredible comeback. They were down by as many as 25 on Wednesday against Evansville. They tie the score but come up short against the Purple Aces. Pickett off the mark on that one. And they really started to heat up. They scored 60 points in the second half and came out shorthanded in overtime. Rebound by Lynch. Taylor.
Good staying in that 2-3 zone. We see a lot of zone for both teams tonight.
Taylor. Freshman inside going up against Lynch. We get our first foul on the red.
Okay, watch the extra pass. Zeislav's going to get trapped here. We're going to swing it to him. Two guys converge, but quickly he knows what he's going to do with it before the trap gets there. Knight is open in the corner. Bang.
Kick it inside. And Tyshawn has started out cold here at Redbird Arena. Lee on the drive.
Beautiful job. Illinois State, much more of a spring in their step than we saw a week ago. Flat-footed in Chicago. They are alive tonight. Now watch this. You come down the court. You already know where you're going with it, and he knows he's going to attack. Boom! I'm gone. Defenders a day late and a dollar short. There's no rotation down, and he just finishes with a simple layup. This is what you do in practice every day. Just get it on the window and knock it down. Well executed in their break situation.
Bird starting 4 of 6 from the field. And a lot of those 6 field goal attempts have been high percentage shots here in the opening near 4 minutes of this telecast.
If I'm Dan Muller, I couldn't draw it up any better for a start.
Lemon Jr. And a nice hustle by Barnes to keep it alive at a fresh 35.
He not only tipped it, he went and tracked it down himself.
Well, he's really long. First time I've seen Bradley up live here this season. Taylor inside. Boy, they can't buy a bucket right now, Dave.
Can't get it to go, and a real nice job extending the zone. This zone is so much more active than what we saw when you and I were together last time. They are out to contested passes, swarming when the ball comes into the paint. Very good energy.
Hunter with a beautiful pass inside. Samuel with the finish.
That's how you beat a zone. You go inside, and then you make your move, whether you run an interior pass to the baseline like they just did, or you kick to the corners, which they got open looks at with.
Knowing more of his scoring prowess, but what a beautiful vision and pass there for the assist. Take a break. Just getting warmed up here at Redbird Arena. But right now, the Redbirds are boiling to a 9-point lead. Valley Conference Game of the Week from Bloomington Normal, Illinois. Hey, be a part of Arch Madness and stop by Perina Dog Chow displays at participating Schnucks and Hy-Vee locations or visit archmadness.com to get your Perina Dog Chow Family Fun Pack. The Family Fun Pack will get you 4 tickets, 4 sodas, and 2 popcorns for only $60. Get your Perina Dog Chow Family Fun Pack today. Bradley Braves, in their incredible history, are playing in their 2,700th game, and they have yet to hit a field goal in the first 4-plus minutes.
Well, how about for Illinois State, though? 5 for 5 and 5 assists on the 5 baskets. They get a dunk, a fast break layup. They get an open 3. They get a curl move in the lane. They're getting it all.
Darrell Bell checks in. He gets the rebound off the miss from Hunter. Barnes, double team, and a turnover. Hunter, good ball movement. Zeislav, and Pickett with the miss.
They missed Zeislav earlier in the possession on a kick out for an open one. There, he wasn't really, I don't think, ready to shoot it. He was readier the first time.
Seen Bradley really work the perimeter here on their offensive possessions early on.
But look where the defense is. They're much more on the ball. Look at that. I mean, just outstanding in a zone concept.
And Bradley still can't buy a bucket. Hunter in transition.
They're just a hot knife through butter right now. Geno Ford's got to be furious what he's seeing defensively. Not getting any help. Nobody rotating over on a dribbler that beats somebody by. He's not going to be a happy camper.
Well, for Bradley, it was a very slow start to a non-conference season. In fact, I was talking to Dave Snell, the longtime play-by-play voice of the Braves, and he's telling me that they had a players-only meeting, and there's finally the first field goal made at the 13-20 mark of this first half for Bradley. But Dave, back to what Dave Snell had told me, is after that player only meeting, it really kind of changed the whole complex of the season. They just kind of had that come to Jesus meeting, if you will, and boy, that really kind of changed the fortunes for Geno's Ford squad. Remember, they're 6-7. They're part of that four-way tie for fourth place in the Valley heading into tonight's game.
Sometimes the senior leaders or the veteran leaders of the club need to step up and take command. It's not a coach's thing. Let's talk about Illinois State, though, in the zone defense. A lot of teams think, I'm not going to play zone. It's a lazy man's defense. No, it's not. Look how they get up on the ball. Look at that pressure. We didn't see that a week ago. I mean, they make it really tough. Then they contest the shot there. I mean, really nice job by Dan Muller's club. He really has spent a good week in practice trying to get these guys where they need to be defensively. It's not just a zone where I've got this area, you got that area. You got to be real aggressive in it.
Hey, I want to remind you, closed captioning for tonight's telecast is made possible by Emerson, the global technology and engineering company. To learn more, visit emerson.com. Emerson, consider it solved. Harris is 68% from the charity stripe. Braves down by nine. Let's see if that finally a field goal may kind of gets them rolling offensively. They have been stymied early on here on the road. Bell, 2-for-2.
What Bradley needs, saddle everybody now, get a couple buckets. Feel like you're right back in it.
Lee on the dish to Lynch. He wasn't expecting it. Limit in transition. Pickett with the finish.
Beautiful. Beautifully done by Bradley. Lynch isn't paying attention. They flip the ball to him. It goes right off his body, and it's a bucket 3 seconds later at the other end.
And just like a blink of an eye, it's a five-point deficit for the Braves. Now Lynch inside, and that is blocked by Pickett. Braves battling back here at Redbird Arena. Pickett with the finish. BU down by five. Play conference game of the week, the I-74 series between Bradley and Illinois State. Time now for a Missouri Valley Conference standings, a presentation of Brina Dog Chow. Help keep him strong, Dog Chow strong. This is exactly what we were just talking about before the break here, Dave. That pack that's right in the middle. Now, Southern Illinois loses on the road today to Indiana State, but you still have Bradley, Northern Iowa, Illinois State. We only have 2 weeks left before Arch Madness. Seeding is really becoming very important with each win and loss here in the final 2 weeks.
No doubt about it. You want to be playing on that upward mobility track when you get to Arch Madness, because you never know what happens. I mean, Wichita State's going to the dance anyway. That Indiana State team, let me tell you something. I thought they would upset Wichita State at ISU. Greg Lansing's done a wonderful job with that program.
In fact, I was talking to the associate commissioner, Mike Kern, today at lunch, and the numbers, when you compare Indiana State and SMU, are pretty dead even.
Yeah.
When you look at RPI, teams you've played and beaten, I think a lot of people kind of overlook them because Wichita State has just been so powerful this year in the Valley.
Wichita State is a team that can win a national title. Greg Marshall's done a magnificent job, but I haven't seen too many teams play, A, as married to what they want to do, and B, as hard as they do. They don't have a 7-foot aircraft carrier. They don't have 5-star recruits. They are just an amazingly good team.
Not the only thing Illinois State has struggled on so far tonight is free throws. 1-4, Lynch with another block. We got a Twitter question tonight here, Dave Kaplan, and it's from Danny Grieve. We appreciate your Twitter question. What will be the key for stopping Walt Lemon Jr. in his scoring tonight?
Keeping him in front of you at all times, and if you see him setting his feet in ball reversal, you got to get out and contest. contest everything. He's a scorer. If you let him beat you off the dribble like we saw there, if they don't have real good help, he's going to score and get his points. Got to keep him in front of him.
Rosser inside, shot clock at three. And here come the Redbirds. Lynch at the block, and he travels. That is his second turnover for Illinois State, who has not scored a field goal in almost 3 minutes.
Lynch is a factor blocking shots, but he's got to be more alert on the offensive end. The first turnover was one they flipped to him. He could have dunked, and it hit him in the chest. This one he travels on. He's got to be more alert in what they want to do offensively.
A little raw, but you can tell he can play the part.
No question about it.
Of course, getting hurt in the last matchup between these two teams with a broken nose. And there you see the face mask that he just put on last Sunday when you and I did that telecast between Illinois State and Loyola. And I understand he's going to have to wear that mask for the rest of the season. That's got to be annoying, I would imagine.
I was just going to say, man, that has to be just a bother.
Ooh. Xavier Taylor robbed on that free throw attempt. He's just a freshman from Chicago. Started the last 12 games, now 13 for Geno Ford. Well, after a hectic start in a positive fashion for Illinois State, things have really kind of cooled down there, which is for the Bradley's favor. Willis on the drive.
Good depth, good penetrating move. Tip your cap, made a play, but I think Bradley's doing a much better job defensively.
Bell on the drive, and we're going to get a foul on Illinois State, and that'll be their fourth team foul here in the opening half of play. Walt Lemon Jr. will check back in, as will Jamal Samuel for Illinois State.
In for Bradley, number 20, Daishon Knight. And in for the Redbirds, number 15,
Nick Zeisloff as well.
And number 5, Jamal Samuel.
Lemon.
That's a score. That is a cold-blooded score.
It was at the bottom of the net. Samuel. Pickett picks up the rebound off the miss from Samuel. Slowly but surely inching their way back into this one early on. Cold start. They were 0 for the first 7 from the field. There's Walt again. And the lead is down to 2 for the Redbirds, just like that.
Geno Ford's guys, no panic in them. Stepped it up defensively until Walt Lemon could get rolling. And now he's hit his last couple of shots, and he's starting to feel it. You could tell.
Graves actually started 0 for their first 8, and now 5 of their last 7, Dave. Lofton can't answer. And there's Lemon Jr. with the rebound.
A lot more settling now from Illinois State. We talked about it in the open. Got to be more aggressive against the zone. You can't just settle for perimeter shots or you're going to get beat.
And we're going to see Paris Lee check back in. There's Lemon Jr. Can't tie the score. Samuel pulls down the rebound. Zeisloft. And a nice job on the rebound by Xavier Taylor. Tell you what, Geno Ford, he's got some athletes on this team.
He does. Ooh. He's done a real good job getting guys down from Chicago. They're starting to assert themselves in recruiting. He has a very good reputation. I'm telling people at Bradley, this guy will get it done.
Walt just lost the handle there. Knight gets the bucket and the foul.
But early it was a blowout. Illinois State's way. Bradley has got Walt Lemon Jr. What a head and shoulder fake. Zeislaw faked out of his shoes. Lemon from way downtown. Boom.
You watch help defense. This is how you play help defense. Here comes Walt Lemon. Look at the help from Samuel. And now the ball's loose. Throw it down the court. There's the hit. Get it up on the window. Boom. 3-point play opportunity. But that is help defense. That's how you rotate over and go, my man was beaten off the dribble. Here comes a great score in Walt Lemon Jr. I'll be there to help bail my guy out.
That lay-in has already given Daishon Knight 9 points here in the opening half. In fact, Illinois State outscoring Bradley in the paint 10-2. And as Dave just mentioned, Daishon has a chance to complete the conventional three here. Make it another 5-point lead for the Redbirds. One for five from the free throw line. Pick it on Lynch. Nice move by Pickett.
Tough shot. I mean, Lynch was right there.
That's against the number one shot blocker in the Missouri Valley Conference. And now Lynch and Taylor doing battle in the paint.
Talk about a tough shot. I mean, Lynch right there, gets a hand right in his face, and he finds a way to get it home. Big time play.
Lemon gets the steal. Lemon with the finish and a foul.
Dude, that may be the most foolish foul I've seen. You're going to foul someone on a wide open break. You can't let him have a ticky-tack and a 3-point play. Sometimes you tip your cap and go, okay, he made a heck of a play, tipped it forward, got the layup. Or I'm going to foul him and he's not getting the open layup. That was something we always preach. You are not getting open layups on us. But a ticky-tack, little tap in the back? Come on.
Now Lemon can't make the free throw to give Bradley their first lead of the night. Boy, there's a lot of contact down low. Hey, we'll let you know tonight's Missouri Valley Conference Scholar Athlete of the Game. Bradley's Walt Lemon Jr., the senior guard from the Windy City, owns a 3.25 CUNY GPA in psychology and has been voted for the MVC Scholar Athlete first team each on the last 2 years. Congratulations to Walt. Darryl Bell. One and done on that possession as Samuel brings down the rebound. And Kadero will pick up the foul. That'll be the 16th foul on the Braves.
Getting physical out there.
It is, man. Nice ball rotation. Knight can't finish. Crosser with the rebound.
Love the shovel pass to Paris Lee. Didn't make the shot, but that was how you find a way to get the ball there.
Right now it's a 13-4 run for the Braves. Tied at 18, looking for their first lead of the night.
2-3 zone still out of Illinois State. We saw a lot of 1-3-1 a week ago.
Bell trying to give him the lead, and he'll get that opportunity at the free throw line.
Foul on number 15,
these two teams are combined 3-for-10 at the free throw line here in the first 14 minutes.
To the line for Bradley, Kadero Bell.
Oh, to remind you, stay tuned for our halftime report, a presentation of State Farm for Auto, Home, Life, and Banking. Get to a better state.
And number 23, Zach,
keep this rate up at the free throw line. Muller and Ford might, both, might, both might be going, uncle.
So you wonder, so like, oh, guys, don't be hard. Just concentrate. Bend the legs. Get into it.
Told you, that's my little pet peeve in this game. Free throws. And it is the first lead of the night for the Braves. 20-18 as we cross the six-minute mark left in our opening half of play of the Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week. Dave Kaplan, Scott Warman with you from Red Bird Arena in Normal, Illinois. Willis lost the handle. Pickett with the defense, and they'll get the timeout.
Nicely done. And not travel on the floor timeout and get the timeout for Pickett. Great dribble, I think, right off of his foot. Here he comes. Just Freddie Keeper, the floor elf, reached up and knocked that one. I mean, I don't know how he lost it.
Looks like he hit his hip. I don't know if he's trying to go behind the back or what. And Gino Ford, there you see, shouting instructions to his team.
He's a passionate, passionate
coach. He is, man. Very well respected, I know, in the coaching ranks.
When you look at him, small guy. And he was a heck of a player.
Fifth all-time in scoring, as I mentioned, during his days in the mid-90s, playing for the Bobcats at Ohio University. He was really dealing early on with the scare with his teenage son. Couldn't figure out for weeks what was wrong, and it ended up being a bad infection. In fact, his son was in the hospital for a while, and now he's doing well. In fact, already graduated from high school. Now some full court pressure by Illinois State. And Lofton's going to pick up the foul.
See, you can hear the crowd upset with the foul call. They're wrong. That is a foul in the way that the game is supposed to be officiated. The rules changed this year. People don't like them. Coaches don't like them. The officials don't like them. But if they don't call them, they're not going to be working. That's the rule.
About a paycheck.
That's it.
And off the rebound, Bradley will pick up a foul now. Paul Jansen, Terry Moore, and Roland Simmons are our officials for tonight's game. And now both teams in the bonus situation at the 5:06 mark here in the opening half of play.
Paul Jansen walked in. He said, check out the game shorts on Illinois State. Where am I, in Indiana? Because they have the candy stripe pants. I love that. I think these uniforms, the retro look, are so cool.
You're going to buy some after the game, aren't you, Cap?
I might get a pair of those shorts to work out in. Might be a little long on my 5'9", 5'10 body.
Be like regular long pants.
They would.
Pants. Got clock down to 10. Crosser, Lemon Jr. Walt on the drive, stops, pops, and he's short. Rebound and another whistle. And it looks like Illinois State's going to pick up another foul.
Well, they've got Walt Lemon a pretty decent look. He made a nice move off a head shoulder fake. Came up way short. But Bradley going hard to the glass. Here he comes. I mean, he's going to give a little fake. There he goes. And he just left it way short.
Chris Blake, Jr. from San Antonio, Texas, checks in for the first time for Geno's squad. Greer hits them both.
Look at Dan Muller. He was a heck of a player. Kevin Stallings over at Vanderbilt, and he's got this program going in the right direction. Really good guy to deal with.
Started 128 consecutive games during his tenure here for Illinois State.
He's an Ironman.
Oh. Lofton. Threes are not dropping for Illinois State. Zach will try to get on the drive.
One of eight from beyond the arc for the Redbirds.
They're going to give it to him. They'll get him the continuation.
Gino Ford. What?
He just went, are you serious? Paul Jansen.
Oh, we're seeing some horrific free throw shooting
it's
here early.
That's good, my friend. One of seven right now for the Birds.
Seven of 17 between the two teams.
Oh, Lemon. How about Walt driving the right lane? They're finding holes in that zone, Dave.
They are. They're attacking the zone.
And a turnover for Illinois State. 3:40 left in our opening half. Walt Lemon Jr. rolling the Braves right now to a two-point lead. Lead with 3:40 left in our Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week. I want to let you know the Larry Bird Trophy is given annually to the Missouri Valley Conference's Outstanding Men's Basketball Player. Emerson is excited to be the prop presenting partner for this year's award. Visit NBCSports.com to learn more. Emerson, consider it solved. Back here just talking before tonight's game, not only just the Larry Bird Trophy winner for this year in the Valley, there's so many different players that have a great chance to be in first-team all-conference. I don't know how you could pick five. It's a shame you can't do seven or eight players. Terrific players like Walt Lemon Jr. just picked up a turnover.
Or you could pick Wichita State for the first team and then take everybody else.
That's a great point. Hunter. And the tip back by Samuel.
No screen out. Samuel doesn't go over the top. Just taps her home. Nothing fancy.
Third offensive rebound in this first half for the Redbirds. Tied at 24. Pick it again at the high post. Now he'll drive. Oh. Nice touch off the glass.
That was a pretty move. Took some contact, found a way to get it up on a glass and knock it down.
Bradley going to a little man-to-man here.
You always want to change what you're doing. If you have it in your arsenal, keep teams guessing.
Rossi coming out on lead. Shot clock at 8. Willis on the drive. Pickett with the rebound.
Nice job by Bradley. Forced him into a tough shot after they were beaten on penetration.
Down to 2 minutes left in our opening half. Pickett on the outside. Boy, he just can't buy a bucket tonight. Lee for three.
Harris Lee was set, ready, get me the basketball. And that's exactly what Bobby Hunter did.
Just the second three make out of 10 attempts in this first half of play for the Redbirds. Greer tries to answer. That was within NBA range. One and done on that possession. And Greer will pick up a foul on the drive from Paris Lee.
Brandon foul on number 44, Omari Greer. That's his second team ninth.
That's the ninth team foul now on Bradley.
Paris Lee.
Illinois State also with 9 team fouls. Now 2 of 3 from the free throw line, and that is only the second free throw make coming from Paris Lee at the charity stripe in this first half from Illinois State. 3 of 9, all three makes coming from Paris. back and forth we go. It's now a three-point lead for Illinois State at 29-26. We see the free throw percentage for these two teams in the opening half of play. Pick it on Samuel. Nice job by Samuel to make Pickett redo his shot. Lee on the drive.
Tell you what, Scott, this game has turned because Bradley took the initial hit and they really have stepped up and made this a heck of a ballgame. I mean, Illinois State came out flying.
Chris Blake checking back in for Geno Ford's squad as you see Tyshawn Pickett taking a seat on Geno's bench. And Nick Zeisloff comes back in. Down to a two-point deficit for the Braves. Under a minute left here from Redbird Arena. Knight on the drive, and it looks like getting a foul on Bradley. Hey, when the MVC TV network takes its cameras on the road, it considers these properties its home away from home. These hotels consistently support the MVC TV network. Please call or visit the websites of these properties for making plans to follow your favorite team away from home.
Tell you what, Dave Kaplan, I don't think I've seen a half of college basketball with the free throw shooting that we've seen here in Central Illinois tonight.
No, I think if I was either coach, I'd say, guys, win or lose, we're staying in the gym for about a day shooting free throws.
They both might be here at Redbird Arena once we get the 40 minutes done.
I feel like you and I could go out and beat this bad.
I'm telling you, I wasn't much of a scorer back in the day, but holy smokes.
Boy, Kadera Bell almost got trapped in a bad spot. Bradley breaks the pressure. Shot clock off. They're down by three. Now Walt will just let this puppy run down.
This game is going to go right down to the wire, I would believe.
Oh, stolen. They've got time. Hunter throws it up, and that will do it. 20 minutes in the books here at Redbird Arena. I-74 series. These two fierce rivals doing battle, tied for fourth place in the Missouri Valley Conference. And right now, Illinois State leads at 30-27. Time now for tonight's St. Charles Convention and Visitor Bureau's plans for the second half as we check in with head coach Dan Muller with our own Dave Kaplan. Dave?
Dan, are you pleased with what you saw? You got up to an unbelievable start and they came back.
I'm pleased with our effort. Walt Lemon's really hurting us. They kind of shut us off on the offensive end. Daishon Knight got us off to a great start, but we got to play with more confidence on that offensive end.
It also seemed like you extended your zone from last Sunday where Loyola got open looks. You took a lot of it away.
We did. Our guys are playing a lot better, and we've been that at home. We're guarding him well, except for Lemon. He's really good, but we got to do a way better job on him.
Good luck in the second half.
Thanks, Dave.
All right, that's Dan Mullen. Let's go back to Scott.
All right, gents, thanks so much. Our chat with the coaches this season is brought to you by the St. Charles, Missouri Convention and Visitors Bureau. We're making plans to attend the 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball Championship on March 13th through the 16th. Go to historicstcharles.com or call 800-366-2427. The I-74 series, part two, slow start for the Braves, but they got rolling in this first half. Right now, the home team, the Birds, are up by 3.
How hot is 99 cents at Wendy's?
Fire!
No, wait! I said my mouth was on fire.
99 cents has never been hotter with two new spicy Chipotle sandwiches.
Conference Game of the Week is brought to you by Coventry Healthcare, an Aetna company, the official presenting sponsor for the NBC TV network. By Emerson, the proud presenting partner of the Larry Bird Trophy. Emerson, consider it solved. And by Pepsi Max, zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Welcome back to our halftime report, a presentation of State Farm for Auto, Home, Life, and Banking. Get to a better state. All right, time now for tonight's St. Charles Convention and Visitor Bureau's plans for the second half as we check in with Bradley head coach Gino Ford with Dave Kaplan. Davey? Our chat with the coaches this season is brought to you by the St. Charles, Missouri Convention and Visitors Bureau. When making plans to attend the 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball Championship, go to historicstcharles.com or call 800-366-2427. As we get set for the second half of play, as Walt Lemon Jr. leading all scorers with 12 points. Meanwhile, two Illinois State players in double digits after the first 20 minutes of play. 10 points for Paris Lee and 10 points for Daishon Knight. As we get set for the second half, these two teams, identical 6-7 records in Valley play in that three-way tie we have right now in for fourth place in the Missouri Valley Conference. Had some technical difficulties there. What did Gino tell you?
Gino said that he's much happier defensively the last half of the first half. He said, we took the initial hit, and then he said, I thought we came back because we defended well, which is what you and I talked about. They really did a much better job at denying that penetration and that easy access into the zone.
Coventry Healthcare, an Aetna company, proudly presents the second half of our Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week from Normal, Illinois. And the Redbirds, with the three-point lead, have our first possession in this second 20 minutes of play. Lynch inside.
I thought he got away with a hook. I really did.
Hey, during Arch Madness, visit the NBC Fan Hangout, presented by Frontier Communications and delivered by the St. Louis Post-Dispatch. The NBC Fan Hangout is located at the Sheridan St. Louis City Center, just steps away from Scott Trade Center, and is the perfect gathering place during the tournament weekend. For additional information, visit archmadness.com/fans. Now, Illinois State, their largest lead in the first half was 11 points. Largest lead for Bradley in the opening half was 2. Barnes, his first three attempt. Money!
That's really nice pass out of the double. Really good job. They double the post, skip it over the top weak side. Barnes buried it.
Knight answers.
Nice job, Zeislop. The kick to Knight. Good quick release. Boom.
Lemon, 4 of 8 from the field in the opening half. This time a no-go for Barnes. Lemon on the drive, too strong. And Hunter comes away with it. And boy, Pick it with that foul.
Let's look at the last two baskets. This is how you beat the double. Here comes the double. Let me skip it right over the top. And there's Barnes. Feet set, shoulders over toes, elbow in. Bam. Really nicely done. And then there's a really nice job. Zaislav, everyone in the building thinks he's going to shoot it from anywhere. He kicks to the wing for an open look.
There's Zaislav from three. And that's going to be Bradley basketball.
Yeah, off of Lynch.
Zaislav, heading into tonight's game, has had 74 field goals attempted in Valley play, only 9 inside the arc. He loves it beyond the arc. Kick out. Greer for three. And more of that contact that we saw down low at the latter stages of the first half carries on the opening stages of the second half, Dave Kaplan.
Yeah, but the foul there, Daishon Knight's like, I'm trying to block a guy who's 5, 6, 7 inches bigger than me. What do you want me to do? And they called him for the block out.
Greer from 15.
Much better rhythm shot there than the three he rushed.
Harris Lee on the kick out. Knight, can he do it again?
Yes, he can. Question asked, question answered.
Moving away from the basketball here, Dave.
Well, watch Greer, and I talk about being a rhythm shooter. This is much more off the dribble, pull up, in rhythm, everything together. The previous shot was a three that I thought he rushed. He wasn't ready to shoot it. And then there's the kick. Best way to a good perimeter look is through the interior. Defense has to shift. They have to suck down to the baseline and come over and take that away. Boom, kick it out. Let's get a good look at it.
Daishon Knight, in fact, now 3 of 4 from beyond the arc. He just checks out. Greer. And boy, what a rebound by Austin Barnes.
I like Barnes.
Man, he's look at his reach, really his wingspan. My goodness.
Junior out of Lansing, Michigan.
Oh, Walt with the triple. Bottom of the twine there, baby. Lee dishing it off to Lynch, and he lost the handle. Turnover. And it looks like Taylor's slow to get up for Bradley.
The third time tonight they've tried to feed it to Lynch in the scoring area, but he couldn't handle it.
15:48 left here in our second half. We've got a good one here from Normal.
Zaislav, it gives you another opportunity. And then Lemon, I mean, that's from almost at Peoria, way downtown. He is just cold-blooded.
That is, what, at least the second, maybe the third shot from long distance we've seen from Walt that's hit the bottom of the twine.
I mean, nothing but... He is a big-time scorer. Mm.
What an incredible career this young man has had in Peoria. You saw Walt shaking his head, didn't like how that whole thing was setting up. Just restarted this half-court offense for the Braves. A three with Tide here, 15 and a half left. Barnes on the drive, keeps it alive. Here comes Willis back the other way.
Nice job, Illinois State. Swarm it, making a tough shot to finish inside on the dribble.
Lynch on Taylor. Two freshmen going mano-a-mano. We take a look at today's Missouri Valley Conference scores, a presentation of Casey's General Store. Casey's, famous for pizza. Battle in Terre Haute earlier this afternoon. Sycamores on top of Barry Hinson's hard-charging Salukis here in the midway point in the second half of the Valley season. And early on right now in the first half, Ray Giacoletti squad up on Loyola.
Ray's got a work ahead of him to turn Drake around. But he lost his second leading scorer earlier in the season. He's got 12 wins already. I'm a huge Ray Giacoletti guy. I've known him, coached against him. I think Ray Giacoletti's going to be wonderful at Drake.
Saw his team on Wednesday and their loss against Missouri State. And I know there are a lot of people that echo your sentiments and the respect that Ray has in the coaching circles.
He does. He's a heck of a coach. Although the last time I coached against him, we beat him.
And you probably remind him of that too, don't you, Cap?
I absolutely do.
Redbirds lead at four right now.
Good defense here.
And Walt on the drive gets fouled. As Akeem picks up the foul, Kadero Bell, you see, checking in for Geno Ford. It really looks like Illinois State, at least early on, has packed in that zone defense. Stretching out a little bit, but not as much as we saw in the opening stages of this game. Turnover by Bradley. Hunter on the drive.
Nice. That is a primo take.
Lemon back the other way. Gets the bucket, and they're going to call an offensive foul. Do they count the basket? Nope. And Geno Ford is ticked.
He wants a timeout so he can let the officials have it. He wants a piece of Paul Jansen. And here's the finish by Hunter. That is just a premium take.
Well, with Dave Kaplan, Jeff Graham, and our Tyron Niles Media Group crew, Scott Warman with you. It's our Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week from Redbird Arena in Bloomington, Normal, Illinois. Let's look at this last foul that was called on Walt Lemon Jr.
Well, here he comes right into your living room, and he slides over that. That is not a charge. Paul Jansen wipes the basket out. I think if he looked at it again, he'd say, I missed that one. That was a block. That should have been a three-point play opportunity. Geno Ford spent nearly the entire timeout bending the ear of Paul Jansen, the official who made the call. Geno's right, the official's wrong. Officials are human. They're going to make mistakes. He made one there.
Well, the interesting part was we were sitting here watching during the timeout as Geno was burning up Paul's ear. And his players were just sitting there waiting for the coach to give him some type of instruction before the timeout ran out. Three by Bobby Hunter.
Boy, he had a really nice penetration in the break, finish. Now he steps back and knocks down a triple. Real aggressive play out of Hunter. They're a better team when he's on the court.
Crosser. They want to let you know you can be a part of Arch Madness. Stop by Perino Dog Chow displays at participating Schnucks and Hy-Vee locations or visit archmadness.com to get your Perino Dog Chow Family Fun Pack. The Family Fun Pack will get you four tickets, four sodas, and two popcorns for only $60. Get your Perino Dog Chow Family Fun Pack today. Lemon Jr.
Wow. I mean, they were not giving an inch to Illinois State, and he found somewhere to get a bucket.
Willis quickly back the other way.
The
think he caught Bradley a little lax trying to get back on defense there.
I don't think they expected Illinois State to attack that quickly. Get the ball in 25's hands.
Inside. Let's see Walt Lemon Jr. work again.
Well, the defense doesn't give a lot, but when he gets himself an open look, I mean, there's just a sliver of daylight. Everybody reacts off the dribble, and he buries a deep triple.
Samuel picks up the foul. And Jamal has two fouls. Now, Reggie Lynch on the bench. He has three. So does Daishon Knight. Now on the other side for Bradley, already three fouls for the freshman center, Xavier Taylor.
But if you're Geno Ford, your team's down seven right now. You're more willing to take chances with your guys. You're Dan Muller. You got a nice little working margin. You got the basketball. No hurry to have to rush somebody in if you feel like I'm doing okay without him.
Keen, nice dish. Boy, Lofton backed out. 10 on the shot. Lofton from downtown, normal.
He backed it out because he wanted three, not two.
I stand corrected.
Going to the store, why won't I get three rather than two?
Second time tonight, Illinois State's had a double-digit lead.
Illegal screen.
Hey, Emerson is proud to bring you tonight's Larry Bird Trophy update. To learn more about the Larry Bird Trophy, visit NBCSports.com. Emerson, consider it solved. Got a couple of young men that we're seeing here tonight. Prime candidates, Walt Lemon Jr., Daishon Knight, DJ Ballantyne, the outstanding sophomore for Marty's squad. And, of course, you got to at least throw in a couple of Wichita Shockers into the mix.
Fred Van Vliet, Clay Anthony Early. I mean, you can go any number of ways there.
Ron Baker. Samuel on Prosser. I'll tell you what, Willis is really attacking the glass. We'll take a break. 11:43 left here in the second half. Birds up by 10 on the Braves. 74 series continues in the second matchup between these two teams in our Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week. Hey, the NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Championship is coming to St. Louis. Experience it live and catch second and third round March Madness action on March 21st and 23rd at Scott Trade Center, hosted by the Missouri Valley Conference. Single session tickets start at only $66. Visit ncaa.com/mbbtickets to make a date with champions. Of course, the madness is just right around the corner.
Right around the corner.
Unbelievable.
The guy who succeeded in March, Dan Muller. Been part of a lot of NCAA teams from being an assistant and as a player.
Braves only 5 of 11 from the free throw line tonight. Make it 5 of 12.
Just dumbfounded.
Speechless.
How that happens. I'm not saying you got to be 12 of 12, but you just can't leave points on the table like that.
Knight in the trap. Again, he's got three fouls. Lofton. Lynch. Boy, working the offensive glass. Number 22.
Big time play. Caught the weak side rebound. Didn't foul. They got it right back up without putting the ball on the deck. Young big guys usually want to dribble it first.
Largest lead of the night for the Birds at 12. Prosser on Lynch. And it looks like Reggie's just picked up his fourth foul.
Reggie was a little out of sync. I think his mask got knocked. Watch him work here. That's just a primo play. Catch it, go right back up. And then when he committed the foul, he went right to the face mask. That's got to be annoying.
Jordan Prosser.
Jordan Prosser, the senior from Brookfield, Illinois. A man who has battled the injury bug during his career with the Bradley Braves.
If Finally, they got one to go.
Now you're acting like a frustrated coach.
I mean, 9 of 17. It just drives me crazy.
Put yourself in Gino and Dan's shoes.
Guys, if we were 13 of 17, add on 4 more points, and all of a sudden you go, guys, it's a 7-point game right there. All of a sudden you're down double digits. Can't make a free throw.
Oh, Lofton was wide open, gets his own rebound, and then that's blocked by Pickett. Hey, register to win a St. Louis Arch Madness VIP package, including all session tickets to the Missouri Valley Conference Men's Basketball Tournament, hotel accommodations, and tickets to St. Louis area attractions. Log on to ExploreSt.Louis.com for complete details. Lynch inside, and he'll go to the line. And Xavier Taylor's trying to talk it over with the official.
He's saying, what did I do wrong? Explain to me what I'm supposed to do. There is a rule called the principle of verticality. You own, as a defender, the space you're standing in all the way up to the heavens. But if your arms come down into the offensive player's area, you're going to get called. And that's exactly what happened there.
Austin
Barnes coming back in for Geno's Bradley Braves. Lemon directing traffic. Barnes drains his second three of the night.
Much needed shot in the arm for the Bradley Braves, but now they've got to get some stops. Got to crank up the defense, got to swarm it and take away dribble penetration.
Daishon. Slides off the iron. Pickett. Outlet to Lemon Jr. Braves down 52-43 as we pass the midway point of our Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week from Red Bird Arena. Dave Kaplan, Scott Warman with you. Walt Lemon Jr. rims out. Willis with the rebound. Wills has really done a nice job attacking the glass on the offense and defensive side of things here tonight, coming off of Dan Muller's bench. Shot clock at 12. Lofton on Barnes, and that's going to be Bradley basketball.
Too much dribbling past the basketball. Dan Muller's saying, well, let's watch Walt Lemon Jr. direct traffic. He's a primo scorer, but he also knows I've got to get everybody where they need to be. And now there he makes a little toss over the top. Barnes loads it up. Boom.
Zach Zeisloft has checked in for the Birds. There's Keane on the drive. Oh, blocked by Lynch. 62 on the year.
Travel, yep. Nice to have an eraser inside. When you get beat, look at that. Get a little bit of help, but you know the last line of defense, the aircraft carrier, is going to be there to knock it away.
62 blocks in just his first year here in Bloomington Normal. I have a feeling there's going to be some records for him. Zeisloft still hasn't found his three range tonight off the bench. Pickett on Lynch. And Reggie did a great job there of making Pickett redirect that shot. Now Hunter almost got it stripped. Move.
Shot clock at 10. And a triple by Daishon Knight.
That's a big one. Gets it back to double digits. Clock drips under 7. 40. And you start to cut the spirit out when you guard so hard. You get the thing back and you think, all right, we're in single digits. You can make a move here.
Daishon Knight shooting 66% from the field, 3 of 4 from beyond the arc. Pickett. And Geno Fort wants to call a timeout here at the 7:24 mark. Interesting, Geno doesn't wait for the under 8. Why is that?
Well, he's thinking, I can't let this thing get away from me. It's gone back to double digits. We just scored. We have got to make a move right now. He may be talking to me, go man-to-man, guys, what do you want to do defensively? We got to force the tempo. There's plenty of time left. It's a three-point shot in the game, and the pace of this game is 7.4 is an eternity, and he wants to get his guys focused. He don't want to look up and go, I should have taken that timeout. Instead, they hit a shot, and you're back to 11, 12 points down.
Walt Lemon Jr. has 18 points tonight, but one of the things we haven't seen in the last few minutes is seeing Walt actually go to the rack. Been mostly outside here last few minutes.
Illinois State has done a very good job at kind of fencing everything off that he's doing. They're verbally passing him along, and they're not letting him that penetrating angle that he had earlier in the first half. That's why he was also able to set Barnes up for a three in the corner.
There's the stop Bradley needed.
Don't need to force it if you're Illinois State, but Bradley, good job to get up the passing lane.
Taylor on Lynch. And Bradley picks up the foul. Daishon Knight, 4 of 5 from beyond the arc for the Birds tonight. And right now, he and his teammates lead it in double digits.
All the games here on the student station said that up until 1923, did you know Illinois State was known as the Teachers? That was their nickname, the Illinois State Teachers.
I did not know that. In 1923, they
said, all right, enough of that. We'll take the Redbirds. And that's when they became the Redbirds. Thank you, Joe.
See? Not only you get the Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week and watch some good basketball, you get a history lesson as well.
There you go.
Only from the I-74 series, Dave Kaplan.
How about the last time Bradley won on this court was the night they named it for Doug Powell, 2007. Hey, Doug, come down here. We're going to lose for you.
Exactly. Right now, these two teams in the second half, much better from beyond the three, 9 of 15, again, combined. There's Walt on the drive, rear wide open. Oh, nice rebound. Pickett gets the putback.
That was a tough rebound. It was. Hanging around. 8-point game. 6:21. Got to get a couple stops and a couple easy baskets.
Lee hits another three.
He has just been money.
Every time Bradley keeps scratching back and clawing the way into this one, there's that one little dagger that keeps that double-digit lead for Illinois State. That one from Paris Lee.
4 of 5 from the floor, 2 of 2 from beyond the arc. Mm. 2 rebounds, 3 assists. That's a pretty good night.
Greer can't answer. Nice. Does it again. That's his 5th triple tonight. Largest lead of the night for the Birds at 61-47. And here come the Redbird fans here at Redbird Arena.
It was an 8-point game just a moment ago. But boom, 2 quick buckets, and you have a nice working margin. You can breathe a little easier. Redbird's banging down threes. Here's the kick to the corner. Look how he's set and ready to shoot. Such a key to shooting. Get your feet set before the ball gets there. And then Knight says, I can do it off the dribble. Way down.
Redbirds are 9 of 20 from beyond the arc. Five of those nine makes from three-point country coming from Daishon.
Don't forget, they were 1 of 8 early.
You see Cadero Bell coming back in for Geno Ford's squad. Well, if this winds up being an L for Bradley, one of the things obviously Geno Ford is going to talk it over with his boys is, boys, we got to go to the free throw line for a couple hours here today.
Yeah, well, all we're doing today is shooting free throws.
Yeah, clock at 7. Another three. This time, Bobby Hunter gets into the party.
They have got it stuck on automatic. They start slow, but they finish on fire.
Barnes hits his third triple tonight.
That kid's really good. I really like the way he plays.
Now we're seeing the Redbirds take a lot more time, Dave, off the possession clock with the double-digit lead as we're under 4 minutes left in this one. Well, an unusual miss beyond the arc for Daishon Knight and Illinois State there.
But they ran clock, 3:29, 13 up. If you really defend well.
Oh, boy, the foul is called. Taylor with some contact inside. Well, folks,
we got a technical foul as well. We'll tell you about it. We'll
it's raining threes at Redbird Arena here tonight.
I don't know if that was the shot Geno Ford was looking for. Walt Lemons open at top. If he had to get it back in his hands and let him create.
See the Redbirds again taking more clock down on this possession with the double-digit lead, the largest of the night at 66-51. Harris Lee. There's Walt Lemon Jr. with the rebound. Now both teams kind of cooling it down from beyond the arc, and it last minute here after the under four timeout.
Yeah, you can start pointing the cars toward Peoria. It's going to be a Illinois State victory tonight. Played really well in the second half. I thought it would go down to the wire. Illinois State really stepped up.
Shot clock down to 6. Hunter with the crossover, steps back. There's Cadero Bell. Fields. Back to Bell. All right, time now for tonight's State and MVC history, brought to you by the 2014 MVC Men's Basketball Tournament at Scott Trade Center in St. Louis. Let's go back to 97, led by Kenneth Pearson's three steals. Illinois State forced a season-high 15 steals as the Redbirds defeated Drake 82-51 right here at Redbird Arena. Make plans to attend Arch Madness in downtown St. Louis on March 6th through the 9th. For more information, visit archmadness.com. With a career high 24 there, and with the bounce pass to Paris Lee.
Illinois State's had a very good second half.
They
defensively
have.
And offensively, they really took control of this game the first 4 or 5 minutes of the second half.
Had a great start in the first half, but really slowed down and Bradley fought their way back. We had a ball game at the break, but Illinois State has really pulled away. And thanks to the three ball, 8 of 14 from beyond the arc in the second half compared to just 2 for 10 in the first half for the Birds.
You know, the Team USA Russia game was this morning, and it got me to thinking as I was doing my research. I saw an unbelievable picture. Jay Blunk is senior VP of the Blackhawks and an Illinois State grad. So he took the Stanley Cup and brought it down here to bring it on center of the court and with the Redbird. It's an unbelievable shot. Check that out. That's Jay Blunk, an Illinois State graduate. And there he is with the Redbird and the Stanley Cup. Pretty cool.
You just had to rub that in, didn't you?
I did, because you're a Blues guy and you're a Cardinals guy. And they always beat my Cubs. But guess what? That's what you're going for.
We're trying. It's been a long time. And look at the hand from the Redbird fans for the starters as Dan Muller is cleaning out his bench here with the lead at 68-53 with 87 seconds left.
I love to see coaches do this. You know, these guys work just as hard as the starters. Some are not even on scholarship, and they do it because they love to be a part of the team and the game. It's a quality move. You got a victory. He gives some guys a chance to say, you know what, I played in that game. My name's in the scorebook.
Meanwhile, Gino obliges and puts in some of his reserves with the final 80 seconds here from Redbird Arena. You and I saw Illinois State last Sunday and their loss against Loyola. We were kind of scratching their heads. What a turnaround in less than a week's time.
Yeah, they look a lot better. A bounce in their step and a really excellent effort knocking down threes after they started, I believe, 1 of 8 from beyond the arc today.
Fields inside. All right, let's get to our players of the game, a presentation of Coventry Healthcare, an Aetna company. Visit CoventryHealthcare.com for more information. Health, wellness, Coventry Healthcare.
Well, Walt Lemon Jr. is a primetime player. He'll go down as one of the top 10 scorers in Bradley history when it's all done. Just not enough Walt Lemon tonight. 18 points, played well, but tip your cap to Illinois State. Defensively in the second half, it took him out of his comfort zone.
Entering to Bradley, number 52, Dave Wells.
Shout out to Walt Lemon Jr. Again, one of those many candidates for the Larry Bird Trophy Player of the Year in the Missouri Valley Conference. Hard to believe only 4 games remaining for these two teams after tonight before we get set up for Arch Madness. And as we told you, these two teams deadlocked with the 6-7 conference records. Three-way tie for fourth place in the Valleys. We're trying to get the whole seeding situation settled for Arch Madness coming up in a few weeks.
Yeah, where did the season go? Unbelievable.
Well, we're past the halfway point of February. Has the shot blocked. Steal by Keane.
Crowd goes crazy. Young man works really hard from Naperville, Illinois. Good for him. He gets a basket here, and the crowd is just over the moon on it.
Matt Stachow, and that'll do it. Redbirds take care of game 2 of the I-74 series as Dan Muller's Redbirds win it by a score of 70-54. All right, let's get to our player of the game for Illinois State.
Daishon Knight, who having a magnificent evening. There he buries a triple. He had great numbers. He was judicious in his shots. Didn't force it. 5 of 7 from beyond the arc. He opened things up, and then it was Katie Barr the door.
Of course, at the end, Matt Stachow gets involved in the party for the Redbirds tonight as they knock off the rivals by 16, 70-54, the final here from Central Illinois. Gotta be impressed. impressed with Illinois State as we head to the final 2 weeks of this regular season, Dave Kaplan.
Illinois State is very tough on this court. They've got to go on the road now and say, you know what, we can win away from the comfortable environment of Redbird Arena.
Enjoyed it as always,
a lot of
friends.
Fun. You got it.
For Dave Kaplan, Jeff Graham, and our Tyre and Niles Media Group crew, I'm Scott Warman. Thanks so much for joining us on Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week from Normal, Illinois. The Redbirds come out on top of this I-74 series. Tomorrow, our Valley Game of the Week with John Rooney and Mark Adams. Wichita State taking on Evansville. Tonight, Redbirds on top of the Braves, 70-54. And good night from Central Illinois.